Motion sensors are the base for any home automations. Today I'm going to show you how this little guy can help you save a lot of energy. This is the Linptech ES1. Let's have a look at what you'll get inside the package. You just have to pull this tab, open the box. Inside we have the instruction manual, the sensor, and a USB-A to USB-C charging cable. The sensor also comes with a magnetic mounting bracket, which is this one. It has a double adhesive backing, so you can stick it to something. And you just have to clip the sensor in like this. You can rotate it and of course adjust the angle. We have the USB-C power on the side. Well, actually I think it's on the bottom side if you look at the sensor like this. This is a status LED that you can't turn off. This LED will turn on blue each time motion is detected, and it also serves as a button that can be used in order to reset or pair the sensor. I have a second one which I have already connected, so let me show you how it looks. I took a normal charger with a sideways charging port. I used the double tape to simply stick the support onto the charger. Then I can take the sensor, clip it in, connect the USB cable. In order to make it look nicer, I can probably do something like this and then connect it up. This way the cable will not be hanging around the charger too much. Now that we got this settled, let's plug it in and see what it can do. Let's have a look at Home Assistant. If we go to Zigbee to MQTT, in devices, Hallway 2 Presence is the sensor that I have added. It's a straightforward process. Full driver is available within Zigbee to MQTT. The image for the sensor is correct. We can see that this is a router. And if we go to Exposes, we can now see the status of the sensor. We can see occupancy that is clear. This is the light sensor, target distance that can be adjusted. For now, I have reduced this to 300 centimeters, which is 3 meters. The maximum is 6 to 8 meters. It's a very sensitive device. We can also adjust multiple other parameters, including fading time. So basically, this is the interval in which the device will check again for presence. Now let's make use of this device. In order to do that, we're gonna go to Settings, Automations and Scenes. And I have already created an automation to turn off the hallway lights. Let's click on it. When do we want this automation to trigger? Basically, this will happen when it reads the Hallway 2 Presence sensor and the state of the sensor switches from detection to clear. Once this trigger is activated, it will go and check if hallway 2 or hallway 1 light are on. This is an OR parameter over here, so if either one of these two matches, it will go and perform the next action. The action defined is switch off hallway 2 and hallway 1. I've set this automation in order to save energy. So if, for example, I leave the light on when passing through the hallway and I leave to another room, I want the sensor to detect that no one else is over there and switch off the lights behind me. Of course, we can make automations also to turn on the light, but for my case, I just wanted to make in a way that it will save energy. Presence sensors are very different than the normal movement sensors, since they are able to detect the presence of a person inside the room. It will detect the smallest changes in the environment, like, for example, breathing. So best use case for this sensor will be if you set it up somewhere where your desk is installed and you have the lights monitored by this sensor. While you're sitting on the chair, even if you're not actually moving, it will still be able to see that you're there and keep the light turned on. When you are moving away from the office, it will be able to switch it off. Millimeter wave sensors like this Linptech ES1 also have another advantage. They can see through thin walls. So for example, if you place this sensor behind a curtain or maybe even a thin door, it will be able to detect that a person is behind the blocker. I have multiple other gadgets coming in, so I hope I can present you more things that you can do by using Home Assistant. That's it for this video. If you found it useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe.